let's talk a bit about The Voice.
Oh, it's all settled,
Rita.
Right?
No, it's all settled. Is The Voice done now? Can we relax? It's all done and dusted, is it?
Anyone who has any concerns about enshrining racial privilege into the Constitution, all the consequences, forget about it. Because Anthony Albanese has come out, and apparently the Solicitor-General has made some comments and everything's fine now.
Oh, so, hunky-dory.
Well, there you go.
I mean, the way this
Well, what were we so worried about then?
Let's just approve everything. I mean, all those other legal experts, you know, former High Court judges and Supreme Court justices, they're obviously confused.
But hang on a second. I'm confused, though, Rita, because, you know, we had this advice, which, you know, admittedly was very narrowly worded.
And
admittedly, it was essentially by the government's own barrister. But, you know, nevertheless, why don't we just take their word for it and not the words of, you know, oh, I don't know. I'm just thinking of maybe some of The Voice's biggest supporters, you know, people like Greg Craven, who have all said, former High Court justices, who have all said, no, actually, this will wind up in the High Court, and that's absolutely fine.
That's the point of having it in the Constitution. It puts it beyond
the department.
It is clear, and yet the way the media reported this, I'm so happy that we've got Chris Merritt on here.
Yes, shortly.
Speaking of the media, you know what else the media seems to have just, you know, run silent, run deep on, was a new poll.
Oh, yes, tell us about the poll.
So a poll from Roy Morgan, which has never been an organisation that has been particularly biased in the conservative direction,
has found
that the support for the Yes camp has dropped by something like 8%, so it's down to around 46%. In almost every single state, Yes is now under 50%
except Victoria,
of course.
Of course.
But the momentum of this thing, and it's really, really interesting. We now are understanding exactly, you know, how right we were to say on this program that the more people found out about The Voice, the less they would be supportive of it. Because now that the No Camp has got their act together, now that they're pushing hard, now that Dutton has put Jacinta Price in as Indigenous Australians minister or Shadow Minister.
It's good that you say belatedly, but let's just remind ourselves and our viewers that this show was saying a year ago we must have Peter Dutton and Jacinta Price standing together and rejecting The Voice. Now, with three of us have argued, we've all talked about it and all this, but fast forward a year later, that is what has happened. Outsiders was there first, calling it first. As usual, I don't mind saying.
You know,
the reality is the strength of that combination and the brilliant ad that Jacinta Price has done with her amazing husband, Colin, who's Scottish. And they again, we've had so many extraordinary insights from Jacinta Price about the damage that The Voice will do. And in this instance, she said, you know, first of all, she made the point that this would enshrine forever Indigenous disadvantage. Mm. That's absolutely true and a great insight.
By design.
But the insight now, which Rita, you've touched on many, many times, is what this does to immigrant Australians or to multiracial families within Australia. Suddenly half the families on one side and half the families on the other. This divides genuinely well-meaning families saying, oh, you're Indigenous. Am I Indigenous? Am I not? Are you? Oh, well, Dad's not Indigenous, but, this is a disaster.
But it just sends the message to others who are not Indigenous that perhaps you're not as entitled to call this
country yours.
But can I just say, if we did have that coherent message articulated from the start
from the Liberal Party,
this referendum would be dead and buried already.
True.
We've had almost 10 months of The Voice having a free run, just a few conservative commentators asking questions, but the overwhelming majority of the media, all the corporate world, all the sporting codes, all the celebrities, everyone's been pushing it. And you look at those poll numbers from Roy Morgan and it's already in trouble. And what that polling also showed, that in every single age group and in both sexes, the numbers are down, so it's not one particular
demographic. And so this, you know, we have to talk about this too, because, I mean, put aside everything you say, Rita, which is absolutely correct, this whole idea that, and you know, you see people who are in the Yes camp now saying, no, it's not about race, it's just whether or not you've been here longer than anybody else. And I mean, like, that to me is just so insane. But this is what we're now hearing from people saying, oh, no, it's not about race. But the other thing that I think is absolutely fascinating now is that, you know, for the last several weeks now, and I think really since the Aston by-election, we've had all these commentators on the left coming out and saying, oh, you know, Peter Dutton is the problem. He's running too hard to the right. And because he's gone no on The Voice, you know, people aren't with him. Well, no. What the polls are now showing is that the people aren't with The Voice. Peter Dutton is tacking in the right direction. All these commentators who would never vote for a liberal in a pink fit have...
Well, I'll tell you what happens when you listen to those commentators, because the Victorian Liberals show you what happens when you listen to those commentators.
Exactly.
They lost badly, not the last election, the one before. And the commentary from the left was, oh, because they're too conservative, because they had one right-leaning policy on law and order. And that was blamed for their loss, despite the fact that it was pretty much the only policy that had any cut-through. So at the last election, they were to the left of Labor on many issues. In fact, there was not a single centre-right policy that the Victorian Liberals took to the poll, and they got absolutely smashed. They stand for nothing.
The reality is, Rita and James, and I'm going to say it here now, Peter Dutton can win the next election. He can win the next election, win The Voice first, and then win the next election. It can be done now. It couldn't be done before. It can be done now. People back a fighter, and this is a fight.